the bartender, give me a drink. I want a cold black glass with bubbles in it. That doesn't mean I can handle anything stronger now. Just think how we do it. I'll have a pint of lager, please, and a pack of Blakey's.
Hiya. Why aren't you at work? Have you got a man here? Have you been making sandwiches for other men? Because that's just too big a betrayal.
I mean, what are you doing here? I thought you were meant to be meeting Gaz for dinner.
And he didn't turn up. And I wanted to show him my pineapple.
Look, you should go. I'm doing private things.
Mm. And Gaz is usually so reliable, like a great big clock. What private things?
I am shaving.
So, what's this then?
Oh, it's a bridal magazine. I was just planning the wedding.
Oh, aren't you the cutest little wife, mate? Let's have a look. Jesus, how fit are these women?
They're bridal models, that's all.
I'm serious. A bloke could have a major commitment problem, but one of these turns up on the doorstep.
Oh, give it back. I only came home so I could read it.
Why couldn't you read it at work?
Because it's nobody else's business, is it? And anyway, I work in a baker's. Pastry, Johnny, pastry. It's a weapon.
Have you actually told them at work we're getting married?
Yes, of course I have. Why wouldn't I tell them? I mean, it's not like I'm ashamed or embarrassed or emotionally crippled by the stress of it all. Okay, no, I haven't told them.
Why not?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I think it's private.
Oh. Have you told your parents?
Well, I'm their only daughter, Johnny, their little girl. It's a bit scary. I'll tell them as soon as we get a venue and a date and a colour scheme and some flowers and a cake and a saxophonist.
Janet, if you don't tell your parents, then I might do.
Well, you're the one who's supposed to anyway.
What?
You're supposed to ask my dad for permission, for my hand and other areas. That's what I always wanted.
Am I? Well, that's annoying, considering how extremely frightening your parents are.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do.
All right, well, you have to do something for me, then.
What?
I don't know, oh, I know, you have to write me a poem about a turtle.
What's the point of that?
I like turtles. And I think I should get something out of this marriage, too.
Well, okay, then. When are you going to ask him?
I'll go around tonight.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Mm. Oh, I can't wait to marry you. Mm. I can do anything I want.
Yeah. Except for weeing on you.
I was cold.
Oh my God, I'm still alive. Help! Help! Someone help me! Oh God, I'm gonna have to chew my arm off like in that film. Driving Miss Daisy. Help!
I can't believe you came all the way back from Australia just to find me.
I didn't.
I think we all know that you did.
I came back to go to school. I mean, at the universities over there, you can major in soup.
So you decided to come and seek me?
No. I got back, I saw you, and before you can say Brit girls are easy, there you were.
There I was. David, you're supposed to say something like, you love the colour of my hair, or you like the way the sunlight catches my dazzling smile.
Why would I say that? That just sounds a bit puffy.
Because, David, I'm beautiful.
Yes, I know. It's obvious you're beautiful. That's why I asked you out.
And I accepted going out with you as a viable option because I could see the potential for change.
You can't just change human beings.
Well, if you can't change them, what's the point in collecting them?
You collect people?
Of course. Only yesterday, the postman became an ally. He used to ignore me, but I answered the door in my Mr. Mennighty and pow! He's changed overnight. Where are you going?
I'm going home.
Are you going home to change your T-shirt?
No. You're mental. I'll call you, OK?
You can't do this to me. I get away with murder. Ah! That's never happened before.
Help! Mr. Wilkins! working soon.
Munch! Oh, thank God. Oh. Munch, you have to help me, man. I've been trapped here all night and I'm pretty sure I've got a ruptured bowel. All these pants are shrinking. Is that funny? I'm stuck.
Hey, hold on a minute. You didn't do this for me, did you, Mr. Wilkins?
Of course not. You're my brother.
Oh, that's all right, then.
What are you doing here, anyway?
Dad sent me, sir. You didn't come into work today and you're not answering your phone. I said you might have got stuck on the bog. I've done it 6 times now. It's suction, you see. It's the power of silence, sir.
Munch, just get me out of these handcuffs.
Can't touch you, not like that.
Why not?
It's incest. Oh, look, your chest hairs grow the same as mine. Do you want to see?
No, I don't.
Does half your pubes grow straight as well?
What?
Mine do. I'm a medical wonder.
Gaz, are you in?
Oh, bollocks.
Did you do this for him? Is he your special secret life partner, Mr. Wilkinson?
Ah! Who are you? And what are you doing to Gaz? It's homoerotic, I tell you.
Oh, I never did it. I didn't do it. And anyway, I'm his brother, so I've got more right to see his muckiness.
Why are you all trussed up like this and in front of your brother as well?
You told me to!
I didn't tell you to do this!
Yes, you did. You said you were getting Janet some patches to stop her smoking, so I should get Donna some sex aids. Why are you dressed in your grandma's suit?
Is your granny a transvestite?
No, I've got to wear this to go around to Janet's mum's later to ask her dad for a hand in marriage. I thought you might want to come to the pub. I need a bit of Dutch courage.
Yeah, I'd absolutely love to come to the pub. Hold on, do you think I'm a bit overdressed?
Do you know what, actually, I was thinking that as well. Does this look a bit twee? I don't know.
I think you look lovely.
Will someone get me out of here?
Fine, all right, fine. Where's the keys?
Johnny.
Yes, Gaz?
The keys would be in my very small, very warm pants.
You're his brother.
No, that makes it 10 times worse, that does. At least you could say you were experimenting.
I experiment with compasses, beasts and sugary snacks, not with other men's parts.
We'll toss for it. Well, I've got the biggest widgie in our family. Go, Munch!
I've never really thought seriously about suicide before.
Johnny, you still here then?
I'll just be going out for a bit.
It'll be easier next time.
I just said, I'm going home.
That's not how you play the game.
I don't play games, Louise.
Well, you've got to. Ah, I know what you're doing.
Yes, I'm going home.
You're playing hard to get. OK, I can do this. Oh, please come back, David, please. I can't live without you.
I just want to get to know you. I don't like games.
Fine, OK. Let's play the game where we ask awkward questions for a while.
Fine, I'll play. Because I do actually really like you. So, what music do you like?
You're a cheeky, cheeky boy.
That was weird. Do you have any pets?
Ah, you'd just love to know that, wouldn't you?
Well, yes. You see, that is the point of asking a question. Ow! Why would you punch me?
You're so silly.
Oh, I'm not that hurt. Can you not see this is wrong? You can't go around hitting people.
David, I can. Where are you going?
Home. I'll see you around.
You can't leave me. You've got to walk me home. It's a dangerous world for a girl like me.
It bloody isn't.
Mom?
Yes, Picklewig.
Do you remember when you and Dad first got together?
Vaguely. He goosed me in the queue for the bar at the Traveller's Rest. We ended the night across the bonnet of a Fiat Panda.
Well, did Dad ever ask you to do anything that you were uncomfortable with?
Of course he did, but don't worry, it'll shrink back up when you have a hot bath.
I'm worried about that.
Is that why you crept into ours so late last night? I thought you were a burglar.
So why did you confront me naked?
Force of habit.
Well, we haven't had sex for a few days, not since I moved in, nearly.
Why not? Are you signing for something?
No, I've just been too busy and too tired, and I wanted to last night. Such a came up.
And he was with another woman. I knew this would happen.
No. He was on the bed.
Well, that's good for a start.
And... But where are you going?
I'm not seeing whipped cream go to waste.
Well,
Louise, I'm really busy. I'm poetising.
Yeah, anyway, Janet. You know David?
Yes, what about him?
He's mature and not in a cheese way.
No. Can you think of any turtle icons other than Touché? Love his work.
No. David's horrible. He won't be manipulated. He won't let me change him. He's too mature. He's like old Play-Doh. Only I wouldn't eat David.
Well, dump him then. Oh, inspiration. Touché away, but were you secretly gay?
But I can't dump him. I love him.
Well, listen, David's nice. He's just a bloke. And you'll find that most blokes don't like playing games. Now, a turtle is hard on the outside, but chewy in the middle like a big bogey.
And I've punched him and everything.
And they don't like being punched, especially not by little incy women.
No, Janet, punching's flirting.
Ah, well, then Cheryl Gascoigne should be bloody grateful.
But I had it all figured out. I thought punching's what you did.
Well, grow up, Louise. Can't you see I'm busy?
I can't grow up. I'm like the ever youthful Lulu featured in Heat magazine. Only I don't need to go, wah! All the damn time.
Just try talking to David like you talk to me. Talk about your life, your plans, ask about his.
And then punch him.
Oh. No, just try and be a grown-up.
Well, that's difficult.
Well, relationships are. You won't keep him if you act immature.
I'll lose him. Like I lost that donkey.
Yes, you have to be grown up. Now, give me a line to follow. A turtle's head is great because...
You gave me the fright of my life. All PVC and whipped cream, you look like a masochistic trifle.
If that's the kind of thing that makes him happy, maybe you should give it a go. And if you don't like it, you say, Brian, you're giving me a chilblain, or some other code word you can think of.
What do you mean, code word?
You really don't know how to live, do you? If you want to tie somebody up or you want to be spanked, then you find you don't like it, you use a special word to make them stop.
What, like kangaroo?
No, a word not connected with sex.
What's a kangaroo got to do with sex?
Don't ask. I still can't look your Uncle Joey in the eye.
It's no good, Gaz. I can't look at you. There was just too much pinkness.
For God's sake, I'm over it. Just think of it as another stepping stone to becoming a real man.
Yes, yes, I do believe it's in that Kipling poem from school, If you can pick some cream-soaked bondage keys from your PVC-clad friend's pubic hair... Then you'll be a man, my son.
It wasn't that bad. At least I'd shaved down there.
Oh! I've touched your shaven John Craven. It makes me guts lurch.
Yeah, let's talk about ladies' boobies. That'll be cheaper.
No.
Come on!
No.
Ladies' bubblies.
Chicken buggy, chicken buggy. Bosoms. Isn't bosom such a bad word? It's so unlike the thing it describes.
What would you call a bosom? You know, in an ideal world, like, cos tits don't really say it either. Tits, tits, tits. It sounds sharp.
Mm. Yeah, and breasts. It sounds slippy. Breasts. Yeah. Yeah? I'd call them, lubber-dubs.
I'd call them, gazports.
Yeah. Yeah. Look, I shouldn't be sitting here thinking about lubber-dubs when I've got to see my future-in-laws. I've got to concentrate. What if they get really angry and throw me out?
Who could get angry with that little face?
I'm serious, Gaz. These people really hate me. At Christmas, right, they've got this Santa, and when I walk past it, it shouts abuse at me.
What does it shout?
It goes like, ho, 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 all gangster rapper-like.
You're just being stupid.
I'm not. I don't know what I can do.
Oh, Johnny, 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 my huckleberry friend.
What does that mean?
Well, you know before when you won the toss to get my keys?
I lost the toss. Lost, Gaz.
Well, whatever. He just did it. You know, grabbed the ball by his horn. So to speak, you know.
Yeah, but so what? That's like doing anything unpleasant. It's like cleaning the toilet. Yeah, you might not want to, but you just have to grab Janet's toothbrush and scrub with all your heart.
Yeah, and that's what you've got to do with Janet's mum and dad. Just get it over with. Why, when I cupped off with bald Shirley for the bet, just ploughed in there and thought of Duncan Gudgeew.
Yeah, you know, you're right. The sooner I do it, the sooner it'll be done.
Nice one.
Right, that's it then. I'm going to seal my future. I'm going to take on the parents and win my woman. I'll crush their icy hearts with this look.
Works for me.
I'm going to say to him, I'm marrying your daughter, and not you, nor any stinking thing in this world is going to stop me. Please. Sir.
And if that don't work, just stick your hand down the drawers. You've got a lovely touch.
I wish Johnny had come back. He's probably still out celebrating. Oh, well, gives me a chance to think of an end line for this poem. Well, what about... And it was all a dream. Brilliant. Do you think they'll take him to the pub and that? No, I suspect they'll be discussing my dowry over some primrose wine, larder cakes and a game of backgammon.
Will Johnny be wearing his favourite cravat and dancing the jaunty gym?
I still not heard from Gaz. I hope he's all right. Did you not even have an inkling he was into, like, S&M?
Well, when I thought about it, I should have known. I've seen photos of him when he was little. That's when it all starts, you see.
Well, so what?
Well, you always had those mittens that tie together through your coat.
You should try it. Just once, a bit of tizzy uppy, whippy, chaily stuff.
Yep, by calling it baby names, you're not making it sound any less dirty.
Well, I think you should give it a go. I had to wear a tool belt for Johnny's pleasure for a while.
Well, maybe you're right. Maybe he did it to surprise me, if that's his thing. Well, I'll try it once. If I hate it, I'll just tell him. I'll use a code word. Kangaroo.
OK, chinchilla. Well, Cass is a nice bloke. He'll understand if you don't like it. I think you'll enjoy it, though.
Well, I did wear a bin bag once, you know, just to see if I look good in it. That was actually quite fun.
What was in the bin bag?
Just me. Oh, and some chicken skin, that was the best bit.
Donna, you're obviously twice the perfect Gaz is. You'll probably teach him a thing or two. Look, just tell him if you feel uncomfortable or if he wants to use gravel or something.
Is Johnny OK when you got rid of the tool belt?
Well, he cries, to be honest. He's then set off this whole adult baby thing. Don't much like that either, especially nappy changing time.
Well, go on then, read his poem.
Oh, OK. To Johnny, the turtle by Janet Smith, poetress. Johnny, you're like my turtle, and being married to you will be turtle-tastic. You have a hard shell and are often scaly, but the best thing is how long turtles last. It's ages-like, and that's just what our marriage will be. Long and very happy, like a turtle.
And it was all a dream. Oh, yes.
Come on. You can do anything. Like a panda.
Pandas can't do anything. They can't juggle or go to Aldi.
This panda can. Grr.
Listen, before you go, I need to ask you. Is Janet up for that Rudy Dirtbag sort of thing in bed?
She's a weird one, is Janet. She'll do anything. Things that even I find disgusting. That's why I'm marrying her.
What, I?
She does things with a cucumber you wouldn't believe.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. I came in once, right? She was lying on the bed, yeah. Right, with, like, cucumber slices on her eyes. Like, mud on her face and a towel around her head. She's pure dirt!
So wait, you think with Donna she should, like, loosen up a bit? Get a bit more experimental?
Well, don't push it, because you could scare her off. You know, just introduce things gradually as you go along. Like me tonight. I won't ask Janet's parents straight away. I'll do the preliminary foreplay first. I'll nibble their metaphorical nipples and the like. Then I'll pounce. Like a panda.
Louise, I wasn't expecting you. I'm working at the minute.
No, no, don't invite me in. This meeting was neither arranged, nor confirmed, nor double confirmed, nor blah.
Why are you doing a dead voice?
I, Louise, Susanna Brooks, girlfriend of you, David, what's your middle name?
Gideon.
not laughing, of you, David Gideon Fish, hereby decree that from this date and inclusive of this date, in pursuant of said parties' amicable wishes, that I will neither play or be playant of the games and or gaming tactics employed by both sexes in accordance with the laws set by herself, Mother Nature.
You won't play sex games?
In conclusion, I will try with the power of God against me to be nice, pleasant, and mature to the best of my abilities in all dealings with lovely boyfriend, if lovely new boyfriend will give me another chance.
Do you want to come in? I've got an iced coffee.
Yay!
I mean, that would be most acceptable.
We can stop talking like that now.
Okay.
And like that.
Mind you, live and let live. I suppose I do eat stock cubes.
Donna!
Who dares enter the lair of the Dominatrix? On your knees, you little worm. You've been a bad, bad boy, and I'm gonna punish you with my dirty sex whip. And if you don't like it, all you have to do is say kangaroo.
I love my new family.
Kangaroo.
Ah, my suitor returns. Come, come. Listen to this. To Johnny, the Turtle by Janet Smith.
Oh, I don't care about that anymore. I like jackals now.
Have you been drinking the dirty beer with my dirty parents?
Not quite.
So what happened? Were they pleased to see you? Did they stroke you?
Well, they've never seen me without you before, so they were a bit worried you'd been run over.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
Mm. So they were relieved at first that you were okay, and then they shut the door again.
Oh.
Yeah. So I knocked again and I asked for Pete.
Who's Pete?
He's your dad, Janet.
Oh. Well, I don't know. He's never formally introduced himself, has he?
Anyway, Pete was in the backyard fixing his mountain bike.
My dad's got a mountain bike. Johnny, are you sure you went to the right house?
No, Janet, I went round to Pete Waterman's house. He said my range was okay, but my dancing really kills him.
Sorry, carry on.
Well, I got down on one knee and I took his hand and...
Johnny, you do that when you propose, not to see the father of the bride.
Yeah, well, I know that now, don't I?
Okay, and?
Well, I said... Pete, I love your daughter more than anything else in this world. She completes me, I said, and I can only truly complete her if you will answer me this most profound of questions. Will you give me the privilege of...
This is so ace, so romantic, so...
Shut up, Gobby! Will you give me the privilege of your daughter's hand in marriage?
Brilliant. That's just what I'd have told you to say.
That is what you told me to say.
Yes, sir, were they excited? Did they open some wine or beer? Did he give you one of his Christmas cigars?
Not exactly.
Well, what then?
He said no.
I've applied for a quickie wedding certificate, and I've asked for any cancellations at the register office.
I haven't got a best man yet.
So you're saying that Donna seduced you?
Do you speak like that because of some physical complaint or because you've never had a good hard shag?
You're stealing me life!
You're marrying me whether you like it or not, and it's going to be frigging marvellous, OK?
Well, I've got nothing to do with this wedding. We're going home. Come on.
I'm the best man!